How to create your value landscape. Put your name and teacher code on the back. Next, you want to decide what orientation you would like your paper to be. And it's also a good idea to create some quick sketches and decide how you'd like the outcome to be of your drawing. You're creating approximately 5 spaces for where your values will go from dark to light. Also, it's a good idea to consider the size of the kind of textured bumps that you'll be adding to your hills and mountains. If you do them very small, it's a little trickier to get precise, smooth brush lines, so it's better to keep them a little bit larger waves or bumps in your hills and mountains. Once everything is drawn how you like, you're going to use black and white and another color of your choice to add your shade. And then you're going to add tints that gradually get lighter as you go towards the top of your paper. At the very bottom, your hill that is closest to you will be the darkest, and that will be the only one that you create a shade. Remember, a shade is when you add black. When you do this, a little bit of black paint goes a long way. Definitely start with less, and if you need to add more, no problem, but you don't want it so that your paint just immediately turns all black. I know in this video it looks very, very dark, but I'll be sure to add a photo where you can see that it is actually just a very dark purple because I have added black to my purple. You can use your paper to mix on, or you can use a placemat or a scrap sheet of paper to mix your paint. When you're adding your line next to your pencil line, be sure to go nice and slow, and you're painting in one way or one direction. You are not going back and forth because it is not a utensil that we're coloring with. You're painting with your paintbrush, so you're picking up your brush every time you add a new brush stroke. And it's a good idea to remember that when you're kind of holding it more straight up and down, you're gonna get more of a thin line versus if you squash your brush down, you're going to get a much wider line. If you're not sure what I'm saying, you can always kind of practice this technique in the open space that you'll paint over top of anyways. And here is where I demonstrate that if you squash your brush flat, you're gonna get a much wider line versus if you're a little more gentle and you just use the very top of your brush. And here's a photo just to see the colors more clearly. Remember, only the bottom hills, mountains closest to you are the ones you're painting a shade with black. For the next darkest color, because we're going darkest to lightest, you're just going to use the original untouched color that you chose to go along with black and white. So no black or no white is added to this section of your project to show gradual change from dark to light. Although this is sped up, it is a reminder to go nice and slow next to those pencil lines you created. Pick up your brush for all new brush strokes. Next, you will create your first tint of whatever color that you've chosen. So you're not really adding that much white yet. Remember to thoroughly rinse your brush between grabbing a new color so we don't muck up the paints for other people that are using them. Start with a little bit of white, and if you need to add more later, you always can do that. Paint is very forgiving, so we can always go back and fix it if we need to. Go ahead and continue this process by adding more white to each section that gets closer to the top. So it should go dark to light. And if you need to, it might be easier to flip your paper over so that you can reach the top without kind of dragging your wrist through your already wet paint.